Now we're talking. Hey guys, Mike here, one go short play. Let's get a bit Bitmap Brothers on it. This is Chaos Engine, or the Chaos Engine, for the Sega Mega Drive. Now my speakers are quite low because I don't want the sound from the game coming into my microphone speaker, and I've not got a particularly sophisticated setup here, as you probably guess. Speaking of which, it might be a good idea to turn my microphone up a bit, because I know the last video was a bit awkward to fix the sound for. Anyway, tangents. Excuse me. This is the Chaos Engine for the Sega Mega Drive. An absolute classic on the Amiga. Very, very nicely designed game. Gorgeous graphics. Look at those graphics. I mean, well, I don't need to say anything about that, do I? That's great. Now, so I'm just doing that thing where you grab your nose and blow in it because my sinuses are all messed up. Look at the art. It's gorge. It's gorge, quite frankly. This was a top-down shooter before they were, those games were twin-stick shooters. And the way they did it on the Amiga is when you shoot, you stop. Your character stops while you hold the fire button. Sounds dead limiting, but you know what? The game was balanced so well, it really worked. The music never translates well to the Mega Drive because of chip tunes and Amiga's like samples. So the soundtrack on the Amiga to this was really proper, big, fat, techno, fun soundtrack. With that kind of alarm noise in it, and it was great, and I had like a storyline going to that and all this character exposition stuff. But let's skip this now. It's the same music, it just doesn't have the same sort of audio dynamics that the Amiga version had. No, we want one player. Oh yeah, no, we want two player, one player and CPU. This is another thing that's cool about the Chaos Engine. Start a new game. Oh, you got passwords for levels, which is good too. So we've got to pick a character. I am going to pick the... I never usually use the priest. Let's use the priest. Oh, is that a priest in this? He's a scientist. He's a priest in the Amiga version. Why is he a scientist in this? I'm sure he's a priest. Am I right? Answers on a postcard. And player two, we'll go with the... someone else we never use. The thug. The mercenary. The gentleman. I quite like the idea of using the navvy. Don't know why. Just do. I think the Amiga has more colours on screen at once, though you don't really lose much on the Mega Drive. I might be wrong about that, although it does look like I am right about that. I'm sure the Amiga's a bit more colourful, a bit more vivid, a bit more varied in the palette. Awesome, they've kept the samples, although they are a little bit crunchy on the Mega Drive. But see the way it's balanced? Now it's not twin stick, it's single stick, so you've got to kind of place yourself and shoot. Now that sounds like it would be rubbish, but it's not, it's great. Your character stops to shoot and you've got eight directions of shot. You can kind of see how that limits the way you play. But you sometimes find yourself competing with player two as well to pick up the coins. Which is fun in a two-player game, unless you want to be cooperative, which is a very cooperative game. And I love games that are cooperative, Streets of Rage and whatnot, the whole brawler genre. I love cooperative two-player. I hate competitive two-player. I hate the whole, you know... I'm not into that whole laddish competition thing. It might be just a backlash to the school days. I'm not a particularly competitive person. I'm one of those quiet creatives that spent all my lunch times in the art rooms. But that's off on a tangent again. Oh, but see, it's still really difficult, this game. It's still balanced for difficulty. I'm actually usually much better at this than that. I think because I was just off on a tangent, so I was not really paying attention. Not that I particularly mind being rubbish at it. Or rubbish out on this video. It's one of those games that you can really take your time and get into, you know. Oh, I forgot about that. That goes straight forward. That goes in whatever direction you're walking at the time. I mean, I don't need to explain that. I've just picked up a KDOI and it's made that door in the tree open. I don't need to explain that. It's pretty obvious what happened there. I love the pacing of this game. It looks quite slow, but when you're playing it, you know, it's... Ow! That was stupid. Stupid, stupid. When you're playing it, it's actually quite frantic. Especially when you get more and more baddies on. I mean, this is the first level, you know. This is where they're making it easy for you. I saw something happen up there. I might be wrong about that. I mean, look at my health already. I've lost a life on the first level and my health's already down. It's not as easy as it looks. I love the background details. Look how simplistic these little creatures on the floor are. But how gorgeously they go together. Just little 8x8 tiles, but they're great. It looks great, this game. And most of the ground is just flat colour, but it's a really nicely chosen colour of mud. And you know, it's just, it's so graphically memorable. Ow. Oh, I'm so close to death. I like the way this dude's got like a little weird laser gun. I don't think the priest had this weapon. This is the priest, I'm sure. I'm certain of it. This character is the priest character. Wow. Ah, epilepsy warning. Whoa. Let's not, let's not beat around the bush here. I think, oh, okay. That would have set some kids off, surely. Oh, look. Secret entrance we didn't know about. Maybe you have to lose life to find it. I love the way player 2 character, CPU controlled, is so cooperative. I love that. You don't really notice. If the character is a bit stupid, you don't really notice it. It seems to be clever enough that you feel like you've got company, you know, and it's great that. They get that just right. Now, I played the Chaos Engine 2 on the Amiga, you know, playlist. And, well, I think we're going to find out shortly. I remember it being rubbish by comparison to this. I just love the visual style of this. I love how well designed it is as well, how robust the design of the game is. These little dens, this gauntlet style dens that the monsters come out of, allow you to design around them, you know. So you can create a map like this and then switch the dens on and off, if you like, as you go along. And it works really well. Like, they can appear behind you suddenly, you know, when you're taking on someone in front of you. Like that there, this dude's just appeared back here, look. Just this level design lends itself so well to that sort of surprise attack. And that's where this game gets really difficult later on. When you're just totally being taken by surprise. Unless, of course, you play it lots and then you've had lots of practice and you know exactly what's coming, which is the nature of a lot of these games, I think. Oh yeah, those weird frogs. They're very reminiscent of that Spectrum game whose name I can't remember. I'm sure we're going up there, but I just want to check out what's down here first. Maybe we're not, maybe we can just go down here. No, we will have to go up there at some point. Shoot him. Hang on. Wow. He took a few shots, didn't he? Whoa. Cheers, Navi. Nah, you know what? There are too many options for progression there. Let's go up first and see what's available. There's going to be some key up here or something that's essential. Well, look at the dithering. I bet you don't really see that on the CRT, though. It's a good way of adding extra colours in. There we go. Oh, right, that's all it was. Did we pick up a key? I can't even remember what we picked up. I'm just kind of casually wandering. There's some keys. Oh, hello. Ooh. Okay, that didn't open that, did it? I bet something else opened back there now. Oh, my cat Ginny's outside meowing to get in. Actually, I think Joe's just let her in the house, so that's cool. Oh, the ferrets are back in their little house, by the way, now. They had a good play. One of them fell asleep under my desk. And now they're back in their little house. And, like an idiot, I left one of the doors open when I put them back in. Or they've developed some serious intelligence and figured out how to open it. It's one of the two. And to be honest, I wouldn't put the latter past them. But I think it was me. Which was really stupid of me, to be honest. And you know what? They had the sense to stay put and just go to bed. How cool is that? They were clearly both a bit tired after the little play. But they had the sense to not get out. I thought they'd have well gone. Which is always a pain that's happened before. And we had to put an ad on the town's, well, the village, sort of village town. It's too small to be a town. It's too urban to be a village. But I think they like calling themselves a village. So on the village's Facebook group, we had to put an ad. And someone had found it and brought it back, which was kind of cool. It doesn't happen that often. But when it does, it's such a pain and such a worry and a stress. Oh no, I want to play more. Oh, but time's up. But yeah, no, they're in bed and they're cozy and happy. That is a good game. Well, I knew that, and probably so did you. Chaos Engine, ported over from the Amiga. The Amiga version is infinitely better just because it's much more immersive and richer. I say immersive, it's exactly the same game, but it's richer and the music's more, you know, it's got more channels and more depth to it and better samples than that. Check it out, but do check out the Amiga version as well and you'll see what I mean. Thanks very much for watching.